I'm Anil Kumar, sharing with you a video on rational functions. This is on request from a subscriber who wants a variety which is not existing in my videos. So for him, I have created a couple of questions. Here is the very first one. We need to write equation of a rational function for following set of conditions. The conditions are whole at x equals to 0, vertical asymptote at x equals to plus minus 1, horizontal asymptote at y equals to 0. As x approaches minus infinity, y approaches 0 from lower side, and when x approaches positive infinity, y approaches 0 from the upper side. Positive when x belongs to minus 1 to 0 or 1 to infinity. Is negative when x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 or from 0 to 1, and the function never increases. So these are the conditions given to us. We need to write equation of a rational function. A rational function, as you know, is of the form, let's write down, rational function is of the form of a polynomial divided by another polynomial where q of x is not equal to 0. So that is the conditions given to us. You can always pause the video, answer the question, and then look into my suggestions. So what we will do here is that we'll actually try to place the information on the graph and also make a note in the form of an equation which could be developed from these conditions, right? So let's say r of x is our rational function. The first condition is whole at x equals to 0. So as soon as we get whole at x equals to 0, it really means that we have a factor of x in the numerator and a factor of x in the denominator. When they cancel, then we will have whole at x equals to 0. The second condition is vertical asymptote at x equals to plus minus 1. That means the denominator should be 0 for plus minus 1. So we could write x squared minus 1 as the factor, correct? Or you could write x plus 1 times x minus 1. Same thing. Now the condition is horizontal asymptote at y equals to 0. Okay, so these two, vertical and horizontal asymptotes, let's place them on the graph also. So we have vertical asymptotes at plus minus 1, so let's sketch one. That is the vertical asymptote at minus 1, and this one is at plus 1. Horizontal asymptote is y equals to 0, that is what horizontal asymptote is, y equals to 0. Now that really means that degree of denominator is higher, right? So that means we are looking at the degree, right? So degree of denominator is higher, which is the case till now. Let's move forward. As x approaches negative infinity, y approaches 0 minus. That means we are talking about the end behavior now. As x approaches negative infinity, the graph of the curve approaches from below. As x approaches positive infinity, y approaches 0 from positive side. So it approaches 0 from the positive side. You see that? So that is the end behavior which we have gone from the given condition. Now we have that the function is positive when x is between minus 1 to 0. Now these are the vertical asymptotes at minus 1 and plus 1. What we are saying here is positive when x is belongs to minus 1 to 0. That means, so let me write from minus 1 to 0 is positive. That means we are in this part of the graph, positive, right? Or from 1 to infinity, that means positive here also. So this I'm marking with these light marks. We'll connect these once we go through all that. Negative when x is from minus infinity to 1, so it is negative in this portion, and from 0 to 1, and from 0 to 1. So alternately, it changes to negative and positive. Never increasing. Never increasing means all these lines will be kind of going down. Do you see that? All these lines will be kind of going down. So we could easily connect this part, which is, it has to go down always. So this is it. Here also it has to go down. So that should be the curve of the function. Since we have to go positive here, negative here, and the function is never increasing, I could sketch the function from here like this, crossing the origin, but says hole at x equals to 0. So let me make a hole here at the origin itself and then connect. So that becomes the hole, and now the graph goes like this. Do you see that? So that is how we could actually sketch the graph as per the given conditions. Now, with the given values, you need to test whether it can work out like this or not. Well, the degree of denominator is higher, so as far as horizontal asymptote concerned, it may work. But once you cancel these x's, then you will find that for both positive or negative infinity, we are actually having a positive value, right? Because x squared will make it positive. However, the end behavior indicates that when x approaches positive infinity, the value should be positive. That means the degree of numerator is not 1. I mean, degree of numerator is 1, not 0, right? So that means we do have another factor here of x. So let's put this factor and then check. Also, you will find that if we do not include this x, then the denominator will be actually, if x is less than 1, it will be negative. So it will be kind of going like this, right? As you've seen in most of the cases. So that x takes care of the given behavior. So now we can summarize that the function could be written as, so let me rewrite this function, as x squared over x times x squared minus 1, right? So that becomes the rational function which will satisfy all the given conditions. I hope that makes sense, right? So we'll just finish this off, writing x here, y here, 0 at the origin, minus and plus 1, we have already mentioned. So these are your vertical asymptote, x equals to 1 and x equals to minus 1, correct? So that is how it could be done. I hope that helps. We'll take up few more videos on writing equation of rational functions from the given conditions. And I hope that helps. Thanks and all the best.